working on the film, I think it was amazing to say the least. Of course, I got an opportunity to work with some of the biggest stalwarts, whether it's Shilpa Ma'am, Venus, the production house that's made some of the most fabulous films like Bazigar to Dhadkan to more recently some of the nice hit films. And I think he's partly Barish ka mentor because he's like a live wire, so much energy around him. He is a good dancer. He's obviously to work with young people is amazing because there's this vibe on set and that's fun.
Sure. You also got married during this phase. So have things changed for you personally?
No.
Like professionally things?
Today everyone's working and it's all fine.
So first of all, welcome on eTimes Facebook Live session. It's good to see you back and after a long time.
Yeah,
so tell me, how is it going for you? Like, you know, of course, the last time also when we spoke, it was during the lockdown and again lockdown. Yeah. So how is it going for you right now?
Yeah, it's been going fine. It's just, I was really looking forward to a theatrical release. But nevertheless, I think it's really nice to venture into the OTT space and really nice to have a release on OTT as well.
So how was your experience of working in Hangama 2 altogether? You know, share us about your experience.
So working on the film, I think it was amazing to say the least. And of course, I got an opportunity to work with some of the biggest stalwarts, whether it's Shilpa Ma'am, Venus, the production house that's made some of the most fabulous films like Bazigar to Dhadkan to more recently some of the nice hit films, or director Priyadarshan. I've been a huge fan of his work. I've been following every single movie, whether it was the original Hangama or Hera Fairy and every single movie. So I think I really enjoyed working with the team and Paresh Rawal. Mizan, of course, everyone.
That's quite nice to hear from your end. But, you know, Pranita, like, you know, since you have worked for so long and you have been a part of this, you know, industry for such a long time, you have done a lot of South films also. So, you know, overall, working in South and working, you know, for a Bollywood movie, what is the difference have you noticed personally from your end?
I think there isn't any difference when you're working on a film. Language is very secondary. I think Priyadarshan sir is one person who will vouch for this because he's Malayali. He can't speak great Hindi either. I think that really made me comfortable with that. The director and everyone just believed in the role and everything more than the language. And the entire direction department was Malayali and Tamil, and the camera department was also Tamil. We were shooting in Ooty, which was cheated to be shown as Manali. So I think in every way, I didn't really have a problem with the whole Hindi bit, considering my Hindi may not be the best because I'm from the South and my Hindi is very limited. But I remember like the films that I did meetings for, my Hindi was very, very primary. So I remember them talking, you know, to me in Hindi to check how good my accent is. But here I didn't have that problem. So I think it's beyond the whole language barrier.
So Pranita, like, you know, as I said, like, you know, you have worked in the South film industry. What made you be a part of the acting industry? What excited you to become a part of this, you know, industry?
I don't know, the fact that you can be someone new every day, whether it's, you know, whether it's Hangama 2 or even Karnik's wife, Usha Karnik. So it's really nice. This is the first time, it's the second time I'm a part of a biopic and to play a real life character. She also came to the set and visited us, Vijay Karnik and his wife. So it's really nice. I think that's the best part because every day you get to be someone new, something new. Hangama, of course, fictional characters, but still so much fun, and the travel, the experiences, the different cultures. I think the list is endless.
The film, of course, like, you know, Hangama 2, though it released on OTT, it didn't get that good reviews also, you know, it got mixed reviews. So what are your thoughts on that? Because, you know, the film didn't match up to, you know, what expectations people had for Priyadarshini.
Observed one thing about Priyadarshan's films that almost many of his films have met with reviews like this, mixed reviews, but the audience seems to love it. So I think it's more of an audience film than a critique's film because there are times when, you know, the critiques are too critical, and the audience somehow ends up lapping it up. And this is one such film. I agree that it is not as it's not like a cult comedy like Hangama One, but nevertheless, I'm part of it. So I really wish all of you show me all the love, and I hope the Hindi audience takes a liking to me.
Also, like, it's been seen, you know, during a lot of films, you know, right now, since the films are releasing on OTT, they do get leaked online. Now, you know, Kriti Sanon's Mimi apparently has, you know, got leaked online or all. So what do you have to say about the piracy? Yeah.
Oh,
the film's getting leaked online. Yeah. So what do you have to say on the piracy?
Brought this up because this is something I always wondered, because there was a film I did in Telugu. It's called Attarantik Daredi. And it was a proper theatrical release when, you know, a major number of theatres start, Pavan Kalyan, so much expectations and all of that. But I think just, I think a week before the film came to theatres, first half got released online, and a few days later, the second half, and we all gave up hope on it. And I just remember how the entire industry, the Telugu industry, came together. Everyone tweeted and pleaded and requested the audience to not watch the leaked pirated version and to wait for it and watch it in theaters, and it turned out to be the highest grossing Telugu film of all time back I think this is about 7 years ago. So I think I don't know, I would just think that if only people can be ethical and subscribe, because it's so much effort that we all put in, and then it is sold to a certain OTT platform which has also invested huge amounts of money to buy the film, and the idea is to keep it exclusive. So it would be really nice if people can be ethical and watch it just on the platform. But yeah, you're right, like I've heard of a lot of there are people just it has happened to other films and other web series. Like I remember Game of Thrones being available on a link and nobody had to subscribe for these things, and it's just sad. That's like I think like one of the cons of the film industry. But on the other hand, I think film is always an experience. Even if you can't go to the theaters because of lockdown and other restrictions, if you can have it on your projector or in your home theater or even on your living room TV screen, it will make sense. And that can be possible only if you're watching it on the original, the clarity and everything. Only if you're watching it on the original exclusive platform. So I would request everyone to download Disney Plus Hotstar VIP and watch Hangama 2.
Wow, that's quite a good promotion, I must say. The marketing gimmick, something to learn out, to learn from your end. Like, you know, literally, like, you know, you're promoting the platform.
Boy, everyone should thank me. I think Disney should thank me for this.
But also, like, how was it working with Mizan Jafri? Because he's quite an into cutlet, and, you know, he's quite, you know, all over the place kind of a person, personality, you know. So how was your experience?
Just like in the film, I think there's this scene where Ashutosh Rana says, ye barish ki mendak jaise kyun khud rahe ho, kuch, you know, can you just calm down and tell you, you know, talk. So I just think that he's not completely that, but then I think he's partly barish ka mendak, because he's like a live wire, so much energy around him. He is a good dancer. He's obviously to work with young people is amazing, because there's this vibe on set, and that's fun for sure.
But in the film, as I saw, you both were irritating each other a lot, you know, throughout the film. The kind of, you know, chemistry, like, you know, pulling each other leg, or like, you know, trying to prove each other wrong, you know, in some of the other way. So while shooting such scenes, how was that experience for you? Did you end up like fighting with him?
No, I think supposed to scene where like, oh my God, I hope you're okay, because I still not really know Hindi much. So, you know, in the dialogues, he goes like Lomdi and things like that. And I still be like, hey, what is this? Why do they call this character Lomdi? And like, oh, they're calling you a fox. I'm like, oh, okay. So every day it was like, because in half the scenes, he's just saying really mean things to me in the film. So I don't know, every day it was a new learning, new word to learn. And I'm sure you've seen all the different words that he uses to address me in the film. So, yeah.
And also, like, you know, when you're working on this project and, you know, whatever it is, you know, it was quite good for that matter. I must say that. And, you know, but, you know, there are certain dialogues like, you know, Meri Billi would say meow, Aatankwadi ke bacche. You know, the dialogue delivery was like quite different also, you know. There were so many dialogues where, you know, Ashutosh Rana is actually calling those kids like, you know, Aatankwadi ke bacche, you know, how they behave and all, they behave like that and all. you know, what do you have to say about these, you know, dialogue deliveries, you know, because it was very casual like that, you know, बस ऐसे बोल दिया कि ना family में ऐसे बात कर देते and हो जाता है. You don't, you know, take things like, you know, on your head kind of a thing, but you know, you remove your frustration in a way. So what do you have to say about those dialogues and all in the film?
Yeah, I think especially Priyanka's films have a little bit of cliched Hindi in it. I don't know if you've observed it because, like I said, he thinks in Malayalam and someone translates it into Hindi. So there's a bit of that, you know, old school Hindi, which I think everyone can really relate to. It's not like a Mumbai Hindi or like Delhi ki Hindi ya phir like, you know, Urdu wali Hindi. There are like so many different types of Hindi, I'm sure you know.
Yeah.
And Hindi, I think, is like little cliched Hindi, like where he uses these idioms, he uses these phrases. And I've seen on set also, like, especially when you're learning Hindi, you end up learning the cliched, the bookish Hindi. So for me, it was like so different while saying these things. I mean, I don't, my character doesn't say these, but I know, I'm really glad that you observed these things and you talked about it.
What about working with Shilpa Shetty? Like, you have scenes with her and Mandir Wale, you know, you guys are going here and there. You know, she's trying to divert your attention from, you know, not going for the engagement ceremony and all. Of course, I don't want to be a spoiler alert kind of a person right now. No, but of course, no, like, you know, how was your experience of, you know, working with her, with Shilpa Shetty?
Obviously amazing. She is a legendary actress. There's no doubt about it. Irrespective of everything that's, you know, she's been through, I think she really stands tall. She brings so much love and light to the set. She walks in and there's this huge energy, and then she's lively, she's fun. She's more lively and fun than us youngsters, because I'm an introverted person and I'm kind of quiet on set, not really like jumping around, talking to everyone and stuff like that. But that is one thing I really want to learn from Shilpa ma'am. The fact that she's so lively, she befriends everyone, and she's very inclusive, because she knows I'm new there and then I don't really know everyone, but she makes sure she includes me in every plan, like whether it's the dinners and you know, all of us talking on set and everything. And also the fact that she's from Mangalore, so we had this whole Karnataka connect there. And and of course, being fit, really fitness conscious. So, you know, both of them. So Mizan was on keto the whole while. And as you know, is on a diet at all times, like her, whatever, like her basic diet. And I was the one ordering Oreo shakes and everything. And now when I watch the film, I'm like, oh my God, Isa, they're all looking so fit. And I look nice and chubby in it. So I'm like, okay. So I think, yeah, that's because of all the Oreo shakes that I kept ordering when I was on shoot.
And you shared very few scenes with Rajpal Yadav, but of course, you know, he brings a kind of twist in his character. Like, whenever he's there in the film, you know, there is some kind of damal which we expect, because it's Rajpal Yadav over there. So how was your experience of working with him, you know, because he's a different person altogether?
I think especially that monologue, honestly, you see, there's this huge monologue. He's like, you know, he's yelling at her and she's like, everyone's suddenly silent, and then Mizan starts clapping. And then the director went cut and the whole set clapped. They were like, wow, like what a comeback, because I think I really loved his monologue. We just did two takes, because these actors are so seasoned that, you know, I think it was only me and Mizan that kept doing retakes and retakes, but it was Paresh sir, Johnny Lever sir, and Rajpal sir. They were just so spontaneous that they didn't have to have any retakes. And they also know Priyanka's style of filmmaking, so they know what he's going to like and what he's going to okay when it comes to the take. So I think it was not hard at all for him.
Akshay Khanna had a cameo in the movie, and of course, you know, since he was a part of Hangama 1, and he had a cameo in this one, and you got to, like, you know, share screen, you know, space with him. But when, you know, he makes an entry, it gives a different vibe altogether and all. So when you worked with him, like, you know, were you reluctant, you know, because it's not that easy to work with him, and, you know, he's like thorough professional, and he prefers to talk less and all like that. So how was your experience of working with him, though?
Honestly, these are actors I grew up watching, and especially Akshay Khanna, somebody my mom is a huge fan of, especially in Dil Chahta Hai. I remember he was like a huge heartthrob when Dil Chahta Hai came, and he was like this super cute guy who falls in love with Dimple Kapadia and stuff like that. So I remember my mom being really, really crazy about Akshay Khanna. So when I just sent her a picture from this, like a secret picture from the set, and I was like, okay, don't leak it out, because I'll really, you know. She was like, wow, okay, you're working with Akshay Khanna. And even I was excited, of course, because he's in Hangama 1 and all of that. But then it also breaks my heart to think how all of us are growing so old so quickly, because you know, when you see him and how he was in those films and things like that. So yeah, but it was really nice that all of us, really all, everybody in my family was so excited that I got to work with Akshay Khanna.
That's nice to hear. But also, like, Shilpa Shetty was going through her tough time also, but that didn't affect, you know, the, you know, her from promoting the film, you know, on social media and all. Like, did you speak to her, you know, during this, you know, during this, what she's going through right now, you know, because of the cases on her husband and all? Did you get time to speak to her at all?
So I've been promoting the film, not really sure if I've got a chance to do that, but yeah, like I said, I've always been a huge fan of the work she does on screen and the her approach to life, whether it was it's fitness, yoga, and like I said, she's a very lively person. So yeah, I haven't really got a chance to talk to her.
So apart from Hangama 2, since, you know, it's done, you're also working in Bhuj, if I'm not wrong, and you know, so how excited are you for that film? Because it's a very big scale film. You know, you have Sanjay Dutt, you have Sonakshi Sinha, you have Ajay Devgan, and you have, like, you know, big characters in that movie, and it's, you know, made on a very big, huge scale. And, you know, the trailer we saw, it was very good and all. So what do you have to say on, you know, working in that project?
Of course, I'm super excited to work with Ajay Devgan, sir. And the fact that it is a multi-starrer, yeah, it's a bit of a bummer that it's a multi-starrer. But then, nevertheless, that story really requires all these actors that play different roles. And it's about the 1971 India-Pak war, where the runway was built by village women. And so I think every character, whether it's Sanjay Dutt's character, Sanjay Dutt sir's character, or Sonakshi's character, mine, I think every character is so different. So and these are real characters that really existed. So It's a different kind of experience. Like I said, this is my first, second biopic. There's the NTR biopic in Telugu that I did. So this is my second biopic, but, and also my, I've done war films before, but this one is like about a real life incident, and definitely different, definitely something I really, I'm really like, fingers crossed, let's see how it goes. Like, every film is different and new.
That's very nice to hear from your end. And, you know, it makes me quite happy for, you know, for sure. But also, Pranita, like, you know, as you said, like, you know, it's a different experience altogether. What are these South films are you working on right now, you know, apart from doing Bollywood films?
Raman Avatara in Kannada. It's got Rishi, Danish Seth, and Rajvi Shetty. It's a modern take on Ramayana, and I'm playing a modern Sita. I don't know. It's a very, very daily life film. It's like a slice of life film, but then when you watch it, you will know why it is called Raman Avatara.
It's called?
Raman Avatara.
Raman Avatara, okay.
Yeah, it does, yeah.
Okay. So, yeah, like, you're playing the modern Sita over there in the film.
Pretty much, yeah. I think when you watch the film, you'll know why it's called that.
Oh, okay. That's nice. Pranita, you also, like, got married recently during this lockdown. And that was quite in a hush-hush. So have things changed for you, you know, because you have to manage your work life and also your personal life?
And ever since. And yeah, just doing one interview after another. And yeah, I've been also reading
I couldn't hear your voice. Could you just,
I've just been promoting the film because I started, like, right immediately they announced the release of Hangama 2, which I had to really, like, rush to Bombay, do the promotional shoots and things like that. And also, when I'm at home, obviously now all the promotions have become online. And I think that's a big bummer, because we were really looking forward to all those, like, you know, how a theatrical release will have crazy amount of promotion, traveling to different cities. In fact, like, people, I've seen how people, especially in families, are huge fans of See a Couple show. You know, all these reality shows, and I was so looking forward to attending all of those, but I think COVID was a big bummer in terms of the whole promotional this thing. And most of it that we're doing is online promotions, and the film's also releasing online items. But yeah, I guess it's like the new normal, so I think all of us should accept how you know, many films of ours might just suddenly end up releasing on OTT, and we will have to promote it online.
But as I said, you know, you also got married, you know, during this phase. So have things changed for you personally?
No,
like, professionally, things?
No, like I said, that's what I've just been promoting ever since. So yeah, that's about it.
Also, like, do you somewhere feel that, you know, once you get married, you know, there, you know, kinds of change in terms of your career? But no, in terms of your career-wise, because, you know, what happens, you know, in Bollywood, you know, there have been actors who have said that, you know, once they have gotten married, you know, their, you know, the kind of films they get has changed. So do you feel the same, like, you know, does that, you know, happen? Do you feel the same vibe or no, as an actress?
No, I think today everyone's like, everyone's working and it's all fine, I guess. So.
And Pranita, like, what one message you have for the fans out there for yourself, you know, for your fans?
Yeah, go ahead, watch Hangama 2, tell me how you like it. That's about it.
Thank you so much, Pranita, for your time and all the best for your upcoming projects. And thank you for telling me that you're working on, you know, so many projects. Of course, you know, next time when I meet you, I'm hoping that it's not a live or it's an Insta, but, you know, we have a one-on-one, you know, interview for sure. Thank you so much for your time. Goodbye.